film is a super hit when the hero shines, but a film is a blockbuster only when everybody else shines as well. I'm very empathetic, like I can feed off what my director is feeling. When you think of a really good moment, do you really think of a good day at work, or do you remember this time when you just laughed out loud?
Sam, thank you so much for joining us. It's a pleasure to have you on Film Companion.
Thank you for having me.
I remember this conversation we had a few days back where I was like, I don't know what all you're doing, because the genres that you're covering in Telugu and Tamil cinema are so varied too, you know. You have Rangasthalam and then Irumbutire, and then Mahanati is going to come up, and
there's a film
in Shivakarthi. Simaraja and all that.
Simaraja, there's U-turn.
U-turn and all.
And so, yeah, I'll be announcing.
And Super Deluxe also.
Super Deluxe.
I'm so thrilled about that film. You seem to be confusing everybody around. You don't know what to expect from you, you know. What is it that you're doing this year?
For me, every year has been a kind of goal. Well, I built up my career to this year, you know, to a point where people will accept me in different roles. People are willing to take me seriously, to see me, to be able to digest the fact that I can be not just the cute face in films, but also do a varied number of roles. So I think everything is built up to this year. So this year is kind of a report card, you know, not just for viewers, but also for me, you know, this is what I've been looking forward to. I always get very lucky with the kind of films that come to me. And this is another such year.
I was reading this interview from 2015 where you said that if you don't get good roles, then probably you'll consider quitting acting.
Yeah, altogether. Absolutely.
But it turned out to be something completely different.
Yeah.
Right? So, can you recall if there was a turning moment in your career in the past 3 years where things started happening for you in a much better way?
My first turning point was, Ye Maya Chesave, I can't take any credit for that. It just happened. You know, I was there, I did an audition and I was selected. That was God's gift to me. But after that, when things were up to me, decisions to me, I think my first turning point of my career was choosing to do Eega over two other masala films that were offered to me with 3 times the remuneration. And this was still Rajmouli Garu and a Fly. So choosing to do this over those two films was my first turning point, because post Eega I started getting films that were more substantial. For the girl had a more substantial role to play because of my choice to do Eega, you know. So there was Manam after that, and there was, you know, there were films that came that required me to perform. If I had gone this way, I would have done the usual 2 rounds with the top heroes and then fizzled out. But I would say that was the first turning point in my career. And then in between, I went a bit haywire by doing all these masala films, and then there was this Anjaan and things like that. That kind of made me wake up, something's not right. You're trying to prove something when, you know, like, when you get typecast, right? As an actor, say, I got into the slot of the cute category, and actually, it's great. People think you're cute. There are girls come in every day and they don't get this chance, but hey, millions of people think you're cute. Just capitalize on that cuteness. But instead, you know, you want to break out of that and you want to do something to challenge that. And that's where I made a few wrong decisions. And then I realized, so why don't you show variation in the slot that you that people have accepted you already for?
Okay. Not this is something you can't avoid. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Right? When you're already accepted for something, why do you want to break out and try to do something else? So just accept something that is given to you and try not to fight it. A lot of actors might get into that trap of trying to fight the flow.
Right.
Yeah, and it took me a while for me to get back to understanding that, you know, it's a big deal that you're accepted in the first place.
Right.
So just like work with what you have. And so I very comfortably, you know, and try to work with what is it that people like about me, and try to just push those limits, you know, but in that kind of peripheral
right.
of things. So hence, good decisions again.
Yeah. Was part of that phase?
Yes, I was definitely part of that phase. There was Terry, you know, there was where I was playing comfortable characters.
Mm-hmm. The past 8 months seemed to be super hectic for you, you know, the wedding and Obviously, you haven't taken a break after the wedding,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Like, you continuously shot for 2-3 films at least.
Yes.
So, has life changed after the wedding? Or is it the same Samantha, just transitioned from one phase to another?
I'm a bit traditional in... you don't laugh, okay? I'm a bit traditional as in, like, as much as I am independent and hardworking, I look up to how my mother, my mother-in-law, my relatives, how they look after their homes and, you know, their husbands. And I look forward to looking after and the house and, you know, and me and Che, we have a very normal approach to things, like everything from writing our provision list to, you know, deciding the menu for the dinner, seeing if everything is there at home, that everything's bought. So, like, day-to-day activities is organized by us. We don't have anybody to organize it for them. So, especially when I'm traveling and I'm not there and I know that he's going to be the one looking after things, it's a bit unsettling. Because I'd like to do that at home. And things have changed, because previously, before marriage, it was just about me, my way of living. But now it's my family is most important, and our home and the way we conduct things at home is very, very important.
Right, right.
It's taken number one importance.
Enough, right. Now, everybody is talking about your upcoming film, right? Rangasthalam, and you're playing Ram Lakshmi there. And how you became that character? Like, was there a process to become Ram Lakshmi, or was just blindly follow whatever Sukumar wanted you to do? You know?
I think just being in Rajahmundry, and every day I would just talk to girls there and I would notice their body language and the way of doing things. And also Sukumar Garu had just unbelievable clarity. You know, like, I feel like this is his core. This is his real core. I always said, why haven't you done films like this before in the past? Like, what made you take so long to come to this? This is who you are. You know, from every single detail, there was heart and soul in it, and there was a glint in his eyes when he explains it. So, it was, here's a man who was so deeply in love with our villages and their way of living, and has so much respect for them that you just want to give this 100%. And that's why, you know, like, I think pleasing my director was pivotal, like, was the most important for me at that point of time. And that's why I did give it my everything.
Okay. Do you find that way of living fascinating, you know, 80s and all? Because
it's absolutely. I find the way they live absolutely fascinating. There's so much strength there, you know. And the way he's written this character as well, she's such a strong girl. And, you know, these days our idea of a girl and being independent is always... she has a big business, drives in a Mercedes Benz or something, and that's your idea of an independent woman. But here is a girl who fends for her family, who walks in the fields every day, who looks after her family. And when people, when you go talk about villages, you only talk about them getting married early, and, you know, like, the girls they have don't have a life. But it's not at all true. The amount of strength that they possess, and what they do every day from morning to a night, there's no girl in the city who can come close to that kind of strength, perseverance, and, you know, their family. It's like, it's lovely that he has written such a character, you know, who's very strong and independent yet from the village, and who's still so innocent and real. It was just such, it was so liberating to play somebody who's not trying to be perfect, like, you know, any other. It was so liberating when your director is saying, okay, you've done this shot, it's nice, now try doing it ugly. Like, try making it ugly.
Like, how do you do that? Like, can you give me an instance?
Like, so he would, even if it's a smile, right? I don't smile like how I smile. I'll smile like, it'll be like to one side. It won't, and nothing, like, no expression is just normal. He just did not want to see Samantha. Everything I did was a bit off. You know, nothing. I tried as much to be ugly, not ugly in, I mean, more, I would say, not try to be perfect, you know. And it was so liberating to not fix your hair and, you know, to just be. And it was, I think that itself was such a weight off your shoulders, because in every film you're just supposed to hair supposed to look a certain way, and, you're, and it's so much pressure on normal girls, and it's so much pressure on you. You don't look like that every day in the morning. So it's such a lovely message, being comfortable in your own skin yet being so attractive because you're so comfortable in your skin.
That reminds me of a tweet that I saw on your timeline, right? Where I think it was one of your fans who asked you, do you really wash all these buffaloes or something?
The buffaloes and the cows were my best friends. People wouldn't understand, we couldn't believe that I was actually buffalo. They were like, CG. What CG? What is wrong in washing buffaloes? Then the buffaloes got extra comfy with me, where there was this shot where it's a long shot, like I would have to pull a buffalo through a huge ground, and so I would pull it, and then an assistant director would take him back to the first, yeah, because it was three, five takes. After a point, the assistant director took him back, he wasn't moving. I had to come and take him back. So I was like, wow, okay then. What is it? What is going on? What do you think? Who do you think I am? Sam? I had chemistry with a buffalo. Yes, that happened. Everybody is very confused. So, yes. But it was lovely. It was lovely. You know, just washing buffaloes and pulling cows and plowing the field. And it was like, it was everything. I lived my whole village life in those 15 days. And
you've never lived in a village, right, before this?
I've never even been to a village. Because I've never even been to a village. Okay. I've never seen that. Because I'm from Chennai. My mom, my parents, they have never even been. So they first, they took me, they left me in Rajmundry. No signal, no phone, nothing like that. And then they said, okay, be Ram Lakshmi. Be this girl who was born and brought up, who plows the field in the morning, washes buffaloes, jumps into streams. Yeah, so just be all of this and wash clothes. But it was a lovely challenge. I am so lucky. I romance a fly. I romance three heroes while shooting for three languages in 3 days. You know, there's Manam. I've been truly privileged for the kind of roles that I have got and keep getting.
Okay, right. Now, everybody keeps talking about Sukumar and his scripts. He writes a lot, I can say that, but...
Yeah.
He also tends to sort of complicate things.
Oh, this is the least complicated Sukumar you will
see.
Okay,
you're going on record to say
that.
Yeah,
it is the least complicated person. This is the most comfortable that I have seen him. This is the most happy that I've seen him. I don't know, I can't say for other films, but I never saw any of the, you know, complications or queries or doubts. This is all heart, I would say. This is absolute heart.
Right. You're working with Ram Charan for the first time. I believe that you were supposed to work with him
in
another film, but that
I keep telling him, thank you. Like, I'm so happy that this is the film that we finally end up doing. This is the film. There's going to be a Charan before Rangasthalam and a Charan after Rangasthalam. This film is just going to catapult him to another league, because he has outdone himself and anyone's expectations of him in this film. He's just fantastic. And the greatest part about him is that he's allowed everybody to shine in the film. He's really allowed everyone to shine for a film in this film. And a film is a super hit when the hero shines, but a film is a blockbuster only when everybody else shines as well.
Shit, that's a headline, Ma. Oh, that reminds me of a journalist now in two films back to back.
I'm a rebel journalist.
In both the ones, yeah, actually, right?
Both?
Mahanati as well as...
Oh, Mahanati, I'm not such a
rebellious thing.
Yeah, but I am ahead of my time. Yeah, you can say that, because that's also set in a sense. That's also period. Well, no, that didn't come in handy. But yeah, it was truly... I have to say this about Charan. It's just that he was so giving. Mm-hmm. He was so giving to everyone, whether it is to me or to Adi or Jagpati Babu Garu, you know, to his director as well. He just let go. This is a film, I don't know, and also for some reason, everybody is at their prime, I would say. Everybody is, whether it is Randy Garu or DSP, the art, you know, everybody is like in it to kill it.
I don't know if you remember anything from the 80s, but what's your early memories from your 90s, you know, early days in Chennai, late 80s, early 90s? Do you remember anything at all about life back then?
You know, I kind of wiped out a lot of my childhood. It is on purpose, I think. I just wiped out a lot of my childhood. I only remember what I want to remember. So, I don't remember much, but thankfully, I have this really empathetic side. So, I can very easily see things from other people's point of view, which is what helps me when I play different characters. It's not that I draw from my subconscious. There's no way I could know what a Ram Lakshmi feels. I'm very empathetic. Like, I can feed off what my director is feeling and what he's seeing in his head. So that is what has helped me play Ram Lakshmi well, because I was feeding off his mental picture of this girl.
That also reminds me of the 1980s era as such. It's been part of almost three of your films, right? Like, Manam was, had a segment there.
Yeah.
Now Rangasthalam, and then next would be Mahanati, right?
Yeah.
So, I don't know what's, like, do roles come to you like that, or do they like putting you in that era? How does it work?
I think that anything that is a bit offbeat, like, I think thankfully until another somebody else comes who can fit the cute category and also the decent acting category, I'll tend to get these kind. So I'm very happy. I'm not encouraging any new talent.
Can you break down this process of playing somebody that you don't relate with at all? Like, what does it take to play somebody like Ram Lakshmi, for instance, or could be anybody, you know, even Seema Rajay? I think
it's it is to not take yourself so seriously. It's to not be so rigid in your ways of thinking and being. I think that has helped me. Being very open to another person's beliefs and pain and, you know, their journey. So that's what helped me, and I feed off that. Like, I'm the happiest when I'm in front of playing a role. I'm the happiest when I nail a role.
And so, you know that when you do it,
yes,
good
I
job.
Know. Yeah. I know it. Well, you know, I'm not going to be humble now, but yeah, I know it.
Okay, this bit is from one of your interviews in 2016, where you said that no matter how much progress you've made in your career, there are still certain insecurities that you haven't gotten over.
Mm-hmm.
It's been 2 years since then. Mm-hmm. Like, have you gotten over these insecurities?
Yes.
I'm
so happy, in fact, to say that, you know, that I'm not the girl from 2016. That, well, it's about time that I'm not the girl from 2016. It's a journey for everyone. It's harder for some and it's less harder for some. It was just cinema, my work was my world. I couldn't see beyond it. It engulfed me. The insecurities obviously were a lot, you know, like I had a lot of negative feelings about myself. And so once you see that it's just a job at the end of the day, you know, it's just people around you that tell you otherwise, but it's still just a job. And that life has so much more, you know, whether it's a family and friends. And at the end of the day, when you think of a really good moment, do you really think of a good day at work? Or do you remember this time when you just laughed out loud with your friends at this things? So I would say that I would remember that time where I just laughed all night about this random stupid thing with my family. So I think it took me a while to understand that, you know, it's just a job and it's going to be okay. That changed me a lot.
When you consider it just as a job, there is going to be retirement at some point, right? Like, or do you don't see that coming anytime soon?
Retirement, like I've always maintained, the moment I don't get what I want, I will retire.
Okay.
Yeah, as of now, that's not happening because...
Oh, you haven't put a date to it yet. Is that what you're saying?
Well, I have put a date as to when I want to have a baby, so...
Okay.
Yes.
You've thought about it already?
Very much. The date has been fixed. Like, as if that's going to happen according to the date that we have fixed. But, well, Che seems to believe so. That it will happen on the assigned date. But yeah, we have definitely fixed that, like, the timeline as to when we want to have a baby. So that would be a break.
Are you ready to talk about it? Like, at least a...
Oh, no, no. Well, then, you know, if it doesn't happen, then listen. Then all eyes will be on Che. As to, yo, man, what's up?
Family reminds me, you know, you've always spoken about wanting to also give a lot of time for that other aspect of your life,
absolutely.
Right? Family, you being a wife. Or now you say that thinking of having a child, right?
Yeah.
So does work take a backseat when all that become your priority? Or how do we see you in near future? Like, if you're not acting, let's say you don't want to act for whatever reason that might be, but what will Samantha be at that time?
When I have a child, that child is going to be my universe. I have the greatest respect for working mothers. My childhood was not very rosy. For all adults who haven't had a very rosy childhood, the first thing they would tell you is they want to give their child everything that they did not have. So that's something that is very stuck with me. And so I think the first few years of having a child, I would not be anywhere. That child would be everything for me.
Fair enough. Yeah, I mean, if you've really thought about this, then...
Yeah. And things do happen according to how I plan them. Che says this, like, you get your way. I was like, no, but I'm so nice. No, you're not. Since, yeah, I remember even in 2010, I remember there somebody asking, when will you get married? I said, I'll be married by 30. I will be married.
You told me this.
Yeah, I will be married. So when you believe in something very strongly and you put that out into the universe that that is going to happen, it is going to happen. I've always been that way.
Now, okay, let's talk about the present. You know, I'm sure a lot of amazing things are going to happen in future, but this year, it's turned out to be a really special year for you, you know, where we see you as, in different roles, like we just discussed. So, but when you think about your own career, has the role of Samantha changed within the industry, you know? Where do you see yourself?
Actually, that's quite interesting. I've actually wanted to hear this from a third person's point of view as to how is Samantha perceived over the years? How has it changed?
Because you're not really competing with anybody, you know, from what I've seen.
This is true. I am competing with myself.
At least in the past couple of years, that's the sense I get.
Yeah, maybe, in the last few years, last maybe 2 years, I am trying to better me. I've only been striving to better me. Maybe before that, yes, I was like, oh, what's she doing? Oh, how do I compete? Oh, how do I compete with such hotness? But over the last 2 years, ever since I'm just settled with, comfortable in my own skin, it's been more about how do I better my last performance? How do I make people stop saying, oh, the Samantha and Ye Maya Chesave? I want to punch anybody who says, but that is your best performance. I was like, I didn't even know what I was doing then. I couldn't even barely say the Telugu dialogues when Gautham Menon wrote 3 pages and I didn't know a word of Telugu. And you're telling me that's my best performance. I will punch you in the face, walk away. You know, that has been difficult on its own. The fact that people still keep saying that my best performance is my first film. So imagine the stress and pressure that I have to compete with myself.
Now that we're talking about AMHS, it's been about, 8 years since that film released, right? Okay, that first shot of you walking in that blue sari, I think it did some magic. People are still stuck there.
Yeah.
The music, I don't know, this combination of a lot of factors.
Yeah.
So they kind of remember them watching the film, the film itself. Maybe, you know, that's also true.
That moment about how they felt. So they can't really, because I've been so much more amazing. Just people not able to understand it. People think they're giving me a compliment when they keep coming up to me and telling me that's still their favorite performance.
But what's your favorite performance, like, which you really want people to appreciate and understand the nuances at least?
No, I think I've been very fortunate about when I feel like I've done something, people do appreciate it for what, like whether it was a Manam or whether it was an Eega, whether it was an people did appreciate it for, nobody ignored it,
That also reminds me, did you discover something about yourself in the past 1 or 2 years, like which probably would not even have dreamt about.
That I was even more fantastic than I imagined I was. A lot of my friends believed that I was enamored by the idea of marriage than marriage itself and settling down. They thought that I would chicken out because of the career that I'm in, because of the amount I love my job, and because of the uncertainty of post-marriage, you know, the industry. My, even my best friend thought that I would chicken out, and so did Che. Che thought that, you know, that not chicken out, but Che always assumed that I loved my job more than I loved him. Okay, this is too much information. Which is really stupid, because I did love him for 8 years, which is really stupid, and was just fishing for too much. A lot of my friends did think that, and I can understand why, because I was married to my job, and I really did feed off it. So I did kind of surprise myself also about how easily I transitioned into this decision of getting married and settling and taking my job as it comes, though giving my 100%. But still, I did not flinch for a second. There was no moment of fear. There was no moment of, oh, my world is coming crashing down at all. Yeah, so I proved a point and how to all my friends and my husband.
Now, a lot of people would think that, you know, given the position that you're in within the industry and your personal life as well.
The way you say that, I sound like some mafia don or something.
The princess.
The position you are in this industry.
It's sort of like a fairy tale from the outside.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. It is a fairy tale.
Anything, everything seems possible and nothing is out of reach for you. But it's not so simple, right? Like what it's being like, Samantha.
Mm-hmm.
So is there something which really bothers you, which you're not able to do despite having all these luxuries around you?
Like you said, now, you know, I know that I don't speak so much about, you know, this whole girl, boy, feminist. I fear that if I do speak, it becomes almost like an anti-men, which is a kind of a problem I am facing with what I keep hearing. And, you know, I'm expected always to say that, you know, okay, this is the problem, you know, there's a problem, there's a divide. Whether you're a man or a woman, it's a struggle, you know, it's a struggle. There's men, there's a struggle. If you're a woman, there's a struggle. So another divide and another struggle in a struggle. The fact that you're doing decently well for yourself, it's not hard for you to survive on a day-to-day basis. The fact that you won this battle, you know, I'm really happy with that. I don't have anything, like you said, I don't have anything to complain about now, an extra complaint that, you know, why is it not the same, you know, I might be the princess of the princess, why am I not the king? I know that, you know, a lot of brilliant, strong women have made a voice which is absolutely fair. It's just that somewhere I feel like it's become a little anti-men.
Mm-hmm.
So, like I said, it's everybody has a struggle, and if you're decently good, you just grab her with both hands and just be thankful.
Malayalam industry has this women's collective there who are fighting for a lot of issues, including pay disparity and gender discrimination and all that. And I've always wondered, like, is it even possible to have something like that in Telugu and Tamil cinema, considering that a lot of you are on the same age group at the moment, at least the top heroines of the day. So do you guys even talk about it? Like, does this discussion ever come up, or was everybody too busy trying to figure out how to fit in?
I haven't really discussed this with any of my peers. First, there should be equal roles.
Right. Okay. We always talked about this.
Yeah, first there should be equal roles. Then let's come to the pay.
Okay.
Maybe Hollywood, yes, they can speak about it, because their roles and their movies are such that both have equal roles, both have an equal part to play in bringing the audience to a film. You know, films like La La Land, they both rest on equally on both shoulders, but they don't have that in Tamil and Telugu.
Talking about better roles, right? So, a lot of people these days are also contemplating producing films. Is that something which have you ever thought about it, like putting together projects?
Yeah, in the future, definitely. I would like to put together projects. It's something that I am thinking about, especially since my family now has Annapurna. So it does make sense putting in projects. But the kind of films I would like to do are like not too extravagant, but a slice of life kind of small films that touch me.
Any film in recent time that really blew your mind, like any language, whatever comes to your mind? Like,
well, actually, it was a performance that blew my mind. Have you watched this film, Battle of the Sexes, by Emma Stone? It's a true story about the tennis match between the guy and the girl. And that film just blew my mind, and her performance just blew my mind. So yeah, that film really, really moved me. That's the only thing that I can think of immediately. But yeah, and these days I feel like the audience are kind of moving away, and they are looking for content. They are appreciating small films that have great content, and they're not looking for who's the star in the film. They're looking for the story to be the star. So that's a very positive sign. I also consider, I am doing films that where there's no star.
Like, but you are the star there, right?
Like, I never ever play a star. I never play the star. I just always play a character. And I am not a star. In my head also, I'm not a star. Which is why the only thing where people will ever get irritated with me is when they ask me for a picture. Even my staff, like, they don't scare with me for anything except when they have to ask me for a picture.
You don't like posing for pictures?
I hate it, because I just don't see why does anybody want a picture with me. Like, what the hell? Why do you want a picture? Why? What do you want to do with that picture? I come across rude to a lot of people because I never don't want to take a picture. In airports and everything, people must think I'm such a rude person. Because it's not because I don't want to stand for that. I just don't see why do you want a picture with me. So the whole star thing just never ever, thank God for some reason, it just never sunk in.
8 years and you've been part of Telugu and Tamil cinema, multiple genres, but you're doing some great work this year, right? But do you still feel like you have a lot to prove, or have you gone past that stage already?
A lot to prove, yes. Well, I would really like to believe that our industry has progressed to accepting married heroines and to know that, you know, Samantha is still the same Samantha they worked with and they signed, and to somehow find it in them to move past, you know, the old times of,
okay. You
know, so that is something that I would like to see in my time disproven.
But have you seen the attitude shift after your wedding and all that? Like,
yeah, there is a mild tilt.
Okay.
But I am hoping that my work, like, you know, post these releases, you know, you see, it's not drastic. It's not drastic. It's not at all what I expected. You know, I expected the worst. But it's not what I expected, for sure. I don't blame them. This is something that has been going on for years. You know, when a heroine gets married, out. It's not their fault. It's just a conditioning. I would like to see that shift. And I would be very proud if that shift happens.
Thank you so much, Samantha. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you
so
much.
All the best for your career.
Thank you very, very much.